Coming up on Bobcat Breakdown, John and Pat analyze the volleyball team and its hottest start in program history. And has the goalie controversy been solved for Eric DaCosta and his men's soccer team? Plus, field hockey looked to continue its Big East campaign with another win. But would that chance go up in flames? And finally, these two discuss their game of the week. All this and more coming up on Bobcat Breakdown. Welcome to Bobcat Breakdown. I'm Drew Feinberg alongside John Franklin and Pat Pitts. How are you guys doing tonight?
Drew, I'm ecstatic to be back at the desk on Bobcat Breakdown, especially with this guy, and excited to see you here, my friend.
Excited to be here. Let's start it right off. The volleyball team is off to its best start in program history, starting the season 13-5 and 5-0 in MAC play. Given that the team was a mere 3-28 one year ago, what do you guys think has been the biggest change for this team from last year to this year?
I'll give you two words, Drew. Chad Davis, the new assistant coach for the volleyball team. You know, he's really came in and changed the whole environment of the locker room for the team. You know, he's really stepped in, taken what he's done in Florida. I mean, his resume is unbelievable. I mean, he's taken 14 teams in his time in Florida to national championships. That's unbelievable. You know what I mean? And back in, when he coached at a high school down there, he went 89-5. I mean, that's unheard of up here. So what you do, you know, when we're when Quinnipiac struggles last year, you know, they have to bring in someone to up, you know, get them winning, that get that winning mentality back. Who do they get? One of the most successful coaches down there, and they bring him into the squad.
Well, Pat, you know, one thing you didn't touch on, even though he went to 14 national championships, or 14 high school championships, excuse me, he did win two of them, so he has the pedigree of a winner. And one thing you didn't really touch on is the freshman talent that's coming. That's a big X factor. I mean, Maria Pansari comes in. She is second in the NCAA in assists with 695. That's unheard of. I mean, her alongside Alejandra Rodriguez, who just won Libero of the Week for the MAC, and Natalie Aleko, who's having a good freshman year. He's coaching them up really well, but really great recruiting on Coach Sablinski's part.
Absolutely. You know, Aleko is one of the leaders in points on the team. She has over 200 at this point of the year. I mean, last year, only three players had over 200 points, and that was at the end of the year, and only one of them only had 300. You know what I mean? So, like, it's just a whole different environment for this team this year. It's a winning environment. You know, they're undefeated in the MAC so far. It's insane to think that, and it's just a whole different program coming in. It's, you know, exciting to watch.
From where they were last year, I mean, Pansari is the biggest star, in my opinion, as a freshman. I mean, she comes in, she's had such an impact on the team. She looks the part. Like, she looks older than what a freshman would be on the court. Yeah. She's unbelievable. She really gelled well with this team, is working well with the older players, like, you know, Cody Michaels and Jen Coffey, who was in her sophomore year. So those are two really strong players that are working around her.
You say Jen Coffey, and Pansari is your top player. Mine is definitely Jen Coffey, just because she leads the team in kills. You know, she's the catalyst for that, you know, offense. And when the ball comes her way, she's spiking it right down, you know, hammering it home, leaving no chance for a defender to come at, you know, to even get close to it. And it's just exciting to watch.
All right, guys, we know that the team has started MAC play with an undefeated 5-0 record. But do you think there's a team on their schedule that will cause them some problems and maybe, I don't know, just beat them for the first time in conference this season?
Well, do you want?
You can go. I started off first.
Yeah, excuse me. I think Fairfield is going to be the team on the schedule to give them trouble, but not until the last regular season game that they have against Fairfield. That one's on the road at Fairfield. I think that they're going to went out up until that game, because you look at their record, they're 4-1 at home, 4-3 on the road. There's got to be some kind of X factor in there that's going to cause them to lose. They have seven straight games on the road before they take on Manhattan and Iona, who they've already beaten. And then they play Marist on the road, but I think that game's winnable if they keep that winning streak going. And then they have to go play Fairfield on the road. I think that's where they lose it.
See, I'm going to agree to disagree. I do agree with you that they're going to lose a Fairfield, but it's going to be their, you know, next game when they play Fairfield and Marist back-to-back. And I think that, you know, they're so hot right now. They're red hot, but you know, I just don't see it continuing that long in the season. And you know, Fairfield has two of the top offensive players in the MAC with Megan Tellier and Skylar Day. You know what I mean? They lead in points and kills in the MAC. I mean, you have two players like that coming to your home gym. They're gonna want to win. They're the next team, top team in the MAC next to Quinnipiac. So it's gonna be an absolute duel between those two powerhouses, and I think it's gonna be a great game. But I think Quinnipiac will just get there.
I don't think they're gonna lose it at home. They've been red hot at home, in my opinion.
But you know, when you're red hot, you know you can always fizzle out, and
When you're red hot, you can also stay hot.
There's a trap game too, and I feel like this is a trap game for them. You know, yes, they are the top team. It's like not the traditional trap game, but I feel like they're riding this momentum, you know, so much that they're just gonna think, oh, we got this, no problem. But then again, you know, Fairfield's gonna say we need to come in to Quinnipiac and we need to win.
It's definitely gonna be exciting to see how this team plays later on in conference play. But switching over to the pitch now, after coming off an impressive 1-0 win on the road against St. John's, the men's soccer team started MAC play this weekend against Niagara. The Bobcats fell 1-0 in overtime with the loss. Are either of you concerned about this result to start conference play?
Not at all. I'm really not concerned about it at all. I mean, you just go on the road to beat St. John's. That's a big game in itself. And the ball just didn't bounce your way in a game against Niagara, in my opinion.
Yeah, I don't see any concern with this, you know, start. I mean, this team's already miles better than the team last year. You know, they're already producing way more offensively. You know, defense could need a little work just because they're getting outshot by every opponent they have. They're getting outshot.
Except in that last game. Niagara 12-7, 6-0 in the first half.
But the whole season they're getting outshot 127-76.
Right.
So, you know, that's kind of – that could be alarming, not concerning. But, you know, this team is just miles better just because they have, you know, freshman talent and soft, you know, undergrad talent.
I mean, I think an X factor of that talent is Rashawn Daly. He had some international experience with Jamaica this summer. I think he'll end up stepping into a bigger role and scoring goals for this team.
I actually think they should maybe be concerned with this start because they finished second to last in the MAC last year, just above Niagara, who did not have a single conference win. So, I don't know. It could.
But Niagara also has a young team as well, a lot of new, you know, freshmen, and they're coming in, you know, a different program as well. So both teams are kind of fairly, you know, fresh right now. So, you know, it's not concerning because they're gonna get better. I mean, they're only freshmen right now. They're gonna produce and they're gonna get to that playoff contention, even a championship contention, you know, along the way.
Coach Eric DaCosta has had quite the goalie controversy on his hands with Chris Yakovitis and Brian Westerman battling for the starting spot. It seems as if the team has found its man in Yakovitis, who has started the last four games for the Bobcats. John, do you think that DaCosta has made the right decision going with the freshman over the experienced senior?
100%. No doubt in my mind. I mean, you come in as a freshman and you expect that there's going to be a difficulty transitioning from the high school game into the college game. Yakovitis had no problem coming from Greece. Now he's in seven games, only let up 5 goals. That's a .74 goals against average. That's much better than Westerman's, where he let up 4 goals against in just 3 games. That's a 1.71. Yakovitis is the guy.
Yeah, I really want to disagree with you and say Westerman, but Yakovitis is playing so well. And, you know, Westerman did struggle against UMass Lowell. Granted, they were undefeated at the time, and they were playing against two of the best in the nation players. But, you know, Yakovitis is just better. He's just the better goaltender right now. He plays the ball really well. You know, he comes out of the net when he needs to. He doesn't play it safe and kind of get stuck in sticky situations. And that's what, you know, makes him that, you know, step above.
I got to agree with you both. I think Yakovitis is the guy for this very young Bobcats team. But we got to take a quick break. When we return on Bobcat Breakdown, we talk field hockey in its most recent Big East matchup. And we have an inside look at the Quinnipiac rugby team. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Welcome to A Sheer Sensation, North Haven's premier cosmetology service, located at 140 Washington Avenue, minutes from Hamden. We offer an array of services, from basic cuts and colors to lash extensions and formaldehyde-free keratin treatments. We also provide hair chalk and styling for men. When you spend $60, your Q card will get you 10% off. Call us at 203-239-2000. 6477 to make your next appointment at A Sheer Sensation.
I could really go for a Ray and Mike sub right now.
Come to Ray and Mike's and try our Philly chicken and cheese for just over $4. Giant cheesesteak subs and mouth-watering boar's head sandwiches for as low as $4.75. Qcash accepted just a mile down the road on Whitney, here at Ray and Mike's.
Welcome to A Sheer Sensation, North Haven's premier cosmetology service, located at 140 Washington Avenue, minutes from Hamden. We offer an array of services from basic cuts and colors to lash extensions and formaldehyde-free keratin treatments. We also provide hair chalk and styling for men. When you spend $60, your Q card will get you 10% off. Call us at 203-239-6477 to make your next appointment at A Sheer Sensation.
Welcome back to Bobcat Breakdown. Field hockey has begun its inaugural season in the Big East Conference. The Bobcats picked up its first conference win against Georgetown. However, the team has dropped its last two matchups, with the most recent being a 6-1 loss to Liberty. Pat, did this loss come as a surprise to you?
No, not at all, really, just because, you know, they're in the new conference. You know, they played Georgetown. It was a great win for them, you know, in their inaugural game to get that nice win, being 0-6 at the time. Coming in and getting that first win at home, but it's a new conference. You know, they're inexperienced in the conference. They're playing, you know, top teams in the nation, not even in their conference, in the nation. And it's just, it's a whole new, you know, kind of system that they just got to get used to. It didn't come to surprise me at all.
Plus, Pat, you got to look at Liberty's resume in the 2015 season, where they beat number 15th ranked Old Dominion 2-1. They beat number 13th ranked in the nation, Delaware 6-2. Took number 11 BC to overtime. This is a team that came to play in the Big East. They're very talented. I think that losing to this team for the field hockey team isn't so bad.
I was not surprised by the loss. I was only surprised by the margin of victory being 6-1. Olivia Gallini only let up 2.6 goals a game. In this game, she let up 3 before getting subbed out. Not her best game, but I was just a little surprised that it was such a large margin of victory.
I have to agree with you there, 100%. But I don't know what to say other than that. I have to agree with you.
Which player do you guys believe has had the most impact on how this team performs?
I have to say Savannah Riley. You know, she's the goal scorer for this team. You know, she is put in front in the middle of that circle, and they're, you know, firing in there to her. She's just hoping for a tip in there, and she's getting the offense going on corners and stuff like that. And, you know, when she's on, the team's on, and we saw that, you know, during the Georgetown game, not so much in the Liberty game, but I think when, you know, she's on, the team is playing really well.
Pat, I got to disagree with you. The most important player to this team right now is Angie King, because she's underplaying. She's going to be important moving forward to get them into the winning mentality. Last year when King scored, the Bobcats were 6-0. They won all 6 games that King scored in. This year, she's got 11 shots. She's only got 1 goal. I mean, she's just not scoring in the quantity that she was last year. I think if she gets going on those penalty corners where they love to set her up, that's what's going to be most important.
Well, she's not scoring because they haven't had any offense to, you know, go off of them. The only time they had,
but that makes Savannah Riley the more important player.
Well, because that's what she's going. She's the one that's getting when the offense is going. She's the one scoring because they have it. But then they're on defense most of the time, and King has to step up and play that defensive role. That's why she's probably one of the best in the nation. And then when they're on offense, they only have limited chances. And when they have those limited chances, they're firing it into that arc, and they're just hoping for a tip from who else? Savannah Riley.
Yeah, and I'm talking about this, the turnaround, though, Pat. If you're looking at a turnaround, if a player's playing well, good for that player. Savannah Riley's playing very well, that's fine. But if you want a player to turn the season around, it's got to be Angie King. If she's going to play better, which we know she's capable of doing, we've seen her play better than this in the past, just because it's a conference transition doesn't mean she should be lowering her quantity and capability of playing.
Right, yeah. You said that she needs to be playing better on the turnaround for them to win. I'm saying right now the hottest player is Savannah Riley because she's playing well.
But this is the most important player.
All right, she is the most important player right now because
she's
scoring.
Not winning, what does it matter?
Let's move on to the next question. With the team's next matchup being on the road against a 2-8 Villanova team, is this a make-or-break game for Quinnipiac as they look to make a playoff push?
100%.
Oh,
100%,
no.
Drew. No. It is no doubt in my mind a make-or-break game for this team. After playing Nova, Nova is 0-2 in Big East play. That's huge. Quinnipiac is 1-1. After that, the rest of the schedule, have you looked at it? Have you done your research?
I have done my research.
I'd love to hear
they
you
have
go
a tough
first.
Schedule. No, they have I'd a tough schedule to coming first. Up. You know, they're playing Providence. They're playing Old Dominion. They're playing two tough teams in the conference.
Tough teams. Old Dominion is 15th in the nation. Talk about tough
that's
teams. Providence hasn't lost in the Big East.
Yeah, that's what I said. Tough teams. So when you know playing against them, they need a win to get you know.
So
going.
They need to win. They need to win
but
against
I'm not
Nova.
But I'm not expecting them to win this game. They don't.
You're not expecting them to win against Nova?
Nova. I don't think they. I don't think they have. They won't
win against Nova.
Thank you, Drew.
I don't think they'll win against Nova.
Even though that's a clip-on bow tie, I appreciate that.
I don't think they'll win against Nova. I think because you know they had the 6-1 loss, they're gonna not. They're just gonna crumble. I don't believe it.
They're gonna crumble. They have to play an 0-2 team in the Big East. Then they go on. They go on to play Providence, who's 2-0. Old Dominion's 1-1. They're 15th in the nation. Temple is the one game after that. Temple is 0-2 in the Big East. That's the game that the field hockey team will probably win in that stretch. And then they play undefeated UConn, who's not only undefeated in the Big East, they're undefeated overall and they're number one in the nation. Now tell me if it's a make or break game for the Bobcats.
They need to win this game, but I just don't.
So if they need to win this game, how can you tell me it's not make or break?
They need to win the game, but I'm saying that if they don't, it's not that big of a deal because it's a new conference. They're getting used to the whole, you know, style of play and all that, and they just.
But
I don't
for the rest of the season, if they lose this game for the rest of the season, it's just looking
you did
terrible.
Do your research because Quinnipiac actually did beat Villanova last year in their matchup, so.
Right.
Could expect the same thing to come this year.
Yeah, it's a new year. Right. New year, new team.
So you're telling me the new team is going to force them to lose?
You don't know. It could happen. I'm saying that this team could come out and beat them like Liberty did. You don't know. And I feel like they can do that.
It's going to be exciting to see how they do in their very young season in the Big East. Now, our very own Victoria Reticoliano got a chance to talk with members of the Quinnipiac rugby team about their lack of home field advantage.
A national championship, a 10-game winning streak dating back to 2015, and an offense that's outscored its opponents by more than 140 points this season. The Quinnipiac women's rugby team is clearly a powerhouse on campus, but what's the one thing it's missing? A home field of its own.
I think the biggest difficulty is not having a regulation field. So even during practice, you know, we're grateful for what we're given, but at the same time, it is hard to take day-by-day practice into a game situation when we're not given a field big enough for us to practice on.
The rugby team currently practices on the former soccer practice field, a field that's 10 yards too short on either side. While this size difference could affect some teams, junior Alona Marr said it's an adjustment they've just had to get used to.
Even in games, sometimes we've had problems of not getting the ball out wide enough because, you know, in practice all we're doing is getting it out to that certain amount, which is the size of our field. So it's taking a lot of adjustment, you know, from going from practice to the games and knowing that, oh, wow, we have so much more room now.
While the field the team is playing on is clearly less than ideal, with the width not being regulation size, head coach Becky Carlson said this is just another chapter in the team's story.
We always have some type of adversity that's attached to our story. And right now, the points aren't the adversity, the other teams aren't that adversity. Right now, this is part of our story. So I think it makes our team more compelling, I think it makes it more interesting, and I think that the fact that we do have a level of adversity each year is something that our team has become accustomed to. So it's kind of like a movie. It's a well-scripted movie where we can just kind of roll with it and keep pushing through and put points on the board, and people are saying, wow, they didn't even have a home field. And that's kind of what I've said to the team. Look at this as part of your story.
This story has been going on for 6 years. So what's it like trying to get future players to come to the school when there's no home field to show the prospective students?
It's a difficult sell. It really is. And, you know, success is a big thing, but we all know that when you come to a facility or you come to a college and you take a visit, you want to see what the facilities look like. We're going right now on our reputation, our unity within the team, and the belief in our staff and our players.
Next season, the team hopes to have a field of its own, the former soccer field, so QU fans can come watch the team play. This is Victoria Rutigliano, Q30 Sports.
We're going to take a quick break, but when we come back, John and Pat will tell us if we should be concerned with the women's soccer team. Plus, these two will discuss their pick for the upcoming game of the week. You don't want to miss this. Stay with us.
Welcome to A Sheer Sensation, North Haven's premier cosmetology service, located at 140 Washington Avenue, minutes from Hamden. We offer an array of services from basic cuts and colors to lash extensions and formaldehyde-free keratin treatments. We also provide hair chalk and styling for men. When you spend $60, your Q card will get you 10% off. Call us at 203-239-6477 to make your next appointment at A Sheer Sensation.
I could really go for a Ray and Mike sub right now.
Come to Ray and Mike's and try our Philly chicken and cheese for just over $4. Giant cheesesteak subs and mouth-watering boar's head sandwiches for as low as $4.75. Qcash accepted, just a mile down the road on Whitney, here at Ray and Mike's.
Welcome to A Sheer Sensation, North Haven's premier cosmetology service, located at 140 Washington Avenue, minutes from Hamden. We offer an array of services from basic cuts and colors to lash extensions and formaldehyde-free keratin treatments. We also provide hair chalk and styling for men. When you spend $60, your Q card will get you 10% off. Call us at 203-239-6477 to make your next appointment at A Sheer Sensation.
Welcome back to Bobcat Breakdown. After getting off to a hot start this season, Dave Clark's women's soccer team has dropped its last three matches, including its first two conference games. Are you concerned with the team's 0-2 start to conference play? John, we'll start with you.
I mean, any team should be concerned when they get outscored 5-1 in two games, but overall, I don't think they should be that concerned. I think that they're playing two teams on the stretch that are going to be tough opponents, you know, Monmouth and Siena, who are both undefeated in MAC play right now. But then after that, they return to Hamden, you know, they're 3-0 at home. I honestly think they're going to go 6-2 down the stretch, finish 6-4 in the MAC.
I disagree. I say that this is a little bit of a concern because, you know, they struggled last year in MAC play early on, and, you know, look where it got them. They missed the playoff spot by a game. You know, so this is the time where you have to look to your, you know, your studs in the team, your top scorers, top defenders, and they need to lead you on to that, you know, path of the turnaround, and they need to get you
right,
back.
Right, the turnaround. The turnaround starts at home when they're 3-0.
I think whenever you start 0-2, anytime in conference play, you should be concerned because there's other teams in the conference who also are pushing for that playoff spot, and if you start 0-2, that's just not
but
a great start.
But
for
there's
them.
Only a few teams ahead of them that are 1-1. I mean, that only takes one win against one of those teams, and they move up a spot. Yeah. It's not that big of a concern.
Yeah, they can get a nice win on the road. You know, they just got to get that momentum back and the goal scoring. You know, Nadia Gill just got to do her thing and
so
just score goals.
So you can see that it's not a concern.
It's a concern because they have to step up and win these two games. They have to win these games if they want to become that playoff contender that they weren't last year. You know, they miss it by a game, and they have very high expectations for this team going into this year.
I agree. But if they're undefeated at home, do you think, and they continue it at home and they go 6-4 to finish the MAC, is that a respectable enough record, you think, to get them to the playoffs?
Well, I think they want to get a top spot. They want to get home field advantage, and I don't think 6-4 will do it for home field advantage.
Right, that's fair.
How is this team similar to the team we saw last season? And also, what do you find different from the team that we saw last season?
I think that they didn't play well at home. I know I'm harping on it, but they didn't play well at home last year. They were 3-5. At this point last year, they were 1-2 at home. So obviously they're doing better in that regard. And last year they were generally a younger team. You move up, you know, Nadia Gill's in her second year after having a great freshman campaign. And then you look at Jess Cascio, who was top five in the team in minutes, if I remember correctly. Last year, she's number two on the team in minutes this year. Those are two key players stepping up for the Bobcats. And just looking at a little different view, Caroline DeBonis and Jess Gargan are playing very minimally, a reduced role from last year.
Yeah, Caroline DeBonis and Jess Gargan were kind of the heart of the defense last year. You know, really kind of the catalyst. And the
Gargan was a midfielder.
Well, they played a lot last year, and they were the catalyst to start the team, you know, to get them to that playoff spot. But then late in the season, they were taken out, and they didn't play to their, you know, full ability. And that's why I think they didn't make the playoffs. And then, you know, this year they come out hot and they don't play a lot, and then that's why they're on the, you know, path they are now.
Where do both of you see their first MAC conference win coming this season?
Wow. Their first MAC conference win. I think when they return home this week, they're going to play Fairfield. Fairfield's below them in the conference rankings, if I remember correctly from what I researched earlier. I think Fairfield's the game for them. They turn it around. That's going to be the turning point for the season, and that's why they shouldn't be concerned going back to that first point.
Yeah, I say they win against Fairfield at home. You know, they're back on their home turf, you know, and they are already undefeated at home. So I think they just get back to that winning ways and just, you know, get a couple goals and score and win.
Sticking with the women's soccer team, Quinnipiac hosts Fairfield in this week's Bobcat Breakdown Game of the Week, with Fairfield also being winless in conference play, as John said. Who do you guys think will earn their first win, as you just said again?
You want to take this one?
Yeah, I say Quinnipiac wins this week, and I, you know, at home, I think they will struggle on the road and then come home and get that nice W.
You know, it's funny, talking to you this week, the whole week you were telling me Fairfield is going to win this game. You told me all week Fairfield is going to win this game. We finally sit down at the desk, and what do you say? Quinnipiac is going to win. Just because of what I did to you last block, I understand what happens. But yeah, I agree. Quinnipiac is definitely the team that's going to win this game. 0-2 for Fairfield. They're not impressing me. Their overall record is 0-4. I think Quinnipiac wins this game.
I got to agree. I think Quinnipiac will come up with this win. I think since they started 0-2, they have fire underneath them. They want to get their first win, and they will come out strong trying to get their first win. I think they will do it.
And, you know, Drew, Fairfield on the road has been very lackluster. They've been outscored 24-7 overall this year. But they've been outscored 14-3 mm-hmm. on the road this year, especially against a team like Quinnipiac that's been playing so well. You gotta count it and put one in the corner for Quinnipiac. I don't know how you're feeling about it, Mr. I'm gonna change my opinion on everything and wear a bow tie instead of a tie today and have my roommate tie it for him.
Yeah, you know, I just think that Quinnipiac will come out on top this weekend. You know, they're gonna struggle on the road just like they have all season, and they're gonna get the home win because they're undefeated already. So. Yep. I think they will come home and win.
Also, Quinnipiac did lose to Fairfield in overtime last season. Do you think that they remember this from last season and they're going to try to play even harder because they did lose in such a terrible fashion last season?
You know, I don't really think that's going to make a huge mark on these players. I think that's going to be, you know, small potatoes when they look back and come into this game. I don't think it's going to matter that much. What do you think?
Yeah, I don't think it'll matter that much. You know, they'll just come back and, you know, they'll get the win.
Well,
yeah.
Pat, I actually have a question for you. What made you change your mind?
Well, maybe change my mind is, you know, they're playing really well at home, and I think that, you know, they are struggling, you know, and they do play well on their home turf, and, you know, they have to get their goal scorers, and, you know, they play better at home.
All right, very nice.
Well, guys, all good things must come to an end, and unfortunately, that's all the time we have this week. Be sure to check out all of our content on Q30Television.com and theQBSN.com. Also, make sure to follow us on social media at Q30Sports and at QBSN. For John Franklin, Pat Pitts, and the entire production crew, I'm Drew Feinberg. We'll see you next time.